One of the big subjects for each or for each subject that you're interviewing is Brexit and Trump as well. Obviously, over the course of the last 63 years or 50 something years that you've been doing this, there's been different politicians in power, different crises that I'm sure that you've engaged with them on. But how much does it feel like this point in time is different for them?
It was a fiasco. I mean,
still is, right?
Yeah, and will be forever. Yeah. But I was really caught out in it because when I was discussing with the studio how much money I can have to do it, I said, well, look, I must have the resources to do a piece about Brexit when it happens. You know, and it may be 6 months after I finish shooting or blah, 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 all that rubbish. But no, I mean, I was very worried about it because I couldn't put the program out with nothing about Brexit. And I got like three little bits from the more political boys there as a kind of reserve. But since nothing happened, I mean, there are a couple of mentions of it, but it didn't. I mean, I thought it could be a huge event, as it probably will be if it ever happens, and particularly with this little group of people, would be a kind of, you know.
Well, you think, I mean, you hear so much both in America and I think in the UK that everybody is very divided and that politics is very divisive right now. But considering all of your subjects pretty much fall on the same line about how they feel about Brexit, whether they voted for it or not, at this point they're all pretty disgusted with what's
but
happening.
It's a general disgust. What's a good word for it? I mean, they're pissed off with the government,
right.
You know.
General.
In general, which right. The British usually are, anyway.
as are Americans, I think.
Yeah, well, both have got reason for it. Mm-hmm. Mr. Trump coming in here on Monday?
Coming in here?
Yes.
No, he was unfortunately not invited.
Oh, okay.
Maybe fortunately not invited. Yes, I don't know.
Yeah, but anyway, I mean, it's you know, I had to do it. If it had happened, but since it didn't happen, I mean, it looked as though it was going to happen before I started shooting. Right. And we had all sorts of contingents. We thought, how clever we are. Here's some money put aside, or here's a few extra days put aside if something happens between us finishing shooting and going out on the air. And really up to about, 10 days before before we broadcast, there was still no resolution of it, so for the last 10 days or so, then I just had to hope the good Lord was on my side and wouldn't throw it at us in the last minute.